I replaced OneDrive with Nextcloud, and if you like privacy, and especially if you like to hold the power over your own data, then you should too. I will show you today how to set up Nextcloud in a Docker Compose setup and use Nginx as a reverse proxy. Now, if you don't know what Nextcloud is, then watch till the end to get access to this Nextcloud we're building right here. And if you're a subscriber, you get 10 gigabytes of free cloud storage to play around with. Nextcloud is super nice. You can use it as storage for your data, for your pictures. You have a calendar, you can chat, you can video call with it. You can use it as a password manager. You can check your emails with it and many, many more things. You can run Nextcloud either in your home lab or you can put it on a cloud server, just what we are doing today. And there's also a app for Android and iOS and also for your PC, similar to Dropbox or OneDrive. Okay, so what do we need for this setup? We need a Linux server first. As I said, we're going to use a cloud server today, but you can run it in your home lab and it will be completely free. We also need Docker and Docker Compose installed, but don't worry, I have videos coming up for those topics as well, so stay tuned for that. And last thing we need is optional, it's just a nice to have, is Nginx. We use it as a reverse proxy and your own domain or subdomain to make it super easy to access it. To start, let's connect to our Ubuntu server and create a new directory. Make directory Docker Nextcloud, and let's change into that. And in here, we're going to create a new file, vim.env, with some environment variables, so we don't need to write down our password in the Docker Compose file. By the way, all those commands and all the files we're creating will be available for download down in the description down below. So in here, we're going to paste in this. I prepared that beforehand. And what this is, we're just going to set up a admin password for the Nextcloud, a root password for MySQL, and a password for a MySQL user. Obviously, you're going to change those into secure passwords. So let's save this. And after that, we're going to create a Docker Compose file, docker-compose.yaml. I prepared that file beforehand, so it's not that much to type, but what we're doing here, we're going to create two volumes to keep the data persistent, or else the Nextcloud will reset every time we restart those containers or the host server. Then we're going to define two services. The first service is for the database. We're going to use the image MariaDB version 10.6. That's from the official Docker Hub Nextcloud documentation. We're going to give it a container name and a host name because I like to keep things organized. We're going to set it to restart always unless we stop it. And this command here needs to run. That's also from the Docker documentation. And as environment, we're going to set the root password. And in here, that's from the .env file that we created just before. So we don't need to write down the passwords in here. And to keep the data persistent, we're going to map the volume DB that we created into var lib MySQL. And let's put this container in its own network so it is all isolated and separated from other Docker containers that we might start up in the future. The second service is Nextcloud. We use the latest image from Nextcloud itself. We give it a container and a hostname as well. Also set it to restart always unless it's stopped. In here, we're going to define that everything that arrives on the port 8020 on the host server will be redirected to port 80 into the Docker container. This Docker container depends on DB, and we also link it to DB. And in here, we have some environment variables as well. So the MySQL host is DB, the database is called Nextcloud, the user for the database is Nextcloud as well, and the password for that user is in here. And same thing again, we have a volume that's called Nextcloud. We're going to pass it through into var www.html and let's put it in the same network. And the last three lines are just to define the network. It's called Nginx network and it's just a normal bridge driver. So let's save this file. I just realized we forgot to start up a tmux session to make it easier to navigate. If you don't know what tmux is, check out my other videos. It's super easy to use if you know your commands. So now that we created our .env file and our docker compose YAML file, we can start up the containers docker compose up-d. And now it will start downloading those images from Docker Hub, one image for the Nextcloud itself, one image for the MariaDB, that's a MySQL fork. And once it's done pulling those in a second, it will start building those containers and running those. You can see here, it created the network, Nginx network, it created those two volumes, and it started those containers. After that, we're going to configure our Nginx as a reverse proxy. Let's open up a new terminal in tmux. And if it's not yet installed, just apt install Nginx. Mine is already installed, obviously. So we can change into etc Nginx sites available. And we create here a new file. Let's call it just like the URL is going to be called. I have a subdomain there, which I already set up a record for this IP address. The sysadminhub.com. And I prepared this already. So let me just paste this in here. And let me just click clean that up real quick. Now, what do we have here? Let me just make this bigger. We're going to tell Nginx to listen to the port 80 and IPv4 and also IPv6. And if the URL is cloud.thesysadminhub.com, it will redirect everything to localhost to the port 8020. And remember, everything that arrives at port 8020 will be forwarded into the Docker container to port 80. And those four lines here are just needed for the reverse proxy. But right now, this is all going to listen to port 80 with HTTP, which has no encryption and is not secure at all. To change that, let's save this file. We're going to set up a SSL certificate from Let's Encrypt. But before we can continue with our Let's Encrypt certificate, we need to finish with our Nginx server here. And for that, we're going to change one directory back into sites enabled and need to create a symbolic link in here, ln-s. And the location of the file we're going to link is in here in sites available. The file is cloud.thesysadminhub.com. And we're going to name the link cloud.sysadminhub.com as well. Now we can test our configuration with nginx-t. It says everything is okay, so we can use systemctl reload nginx. And now we can request a certificate with this super easy command, certbot --nginx- for the domain cloud.thesysadminhub, need to write it correct, .com. Now it's requesting the certificate. I already have one. Yeah, as I said, you need to type everything correct or else it's not going to work. The sysadminhub.com, just like this. now it's requesting the certificate correctly. I already have one because I prepared it beforehand, but I will just confirm to renew it. And now it configured the file. If we check on it, it wrote down a bunch of new stuff in here. But basically what CertBot is doing, it's going to set it to listen to port 443, that's HTTPS, and going to put in those paths to the certificate. So we don't need to change anything in here, so let's just quit this. Now that the web server is done and the containers are running, we can check on our Nextcloud. So enter the URL cloud.thisisadminhub.com. And then it will ask us to create an admin because this is the first time we are starting this cloud, this Nextcloud. So we're going to use admin, set up a password. And now we run into an error, but don't worry, I've encountered this error before. There's an easy fix for that. All right, to fix this, we're just going to enter the MySQL container with docker exec-it, and the name of the container is nextcloud-db-yt, I think, with the bash terminal. And in here we can use the command mysql user root dash P for password. I forgot the password, but we can just check that in our env file. And this is the root password. Let's just copy this, enter it. And now we are inside the MariaDB. And in here, we're going to use this command. It will create a Nextcloud user with the secure password that you're hopefully going to change. And the second command, but they are available for download in the description, is this one. We're going to grant all privileges to the Nextcloud database, to the Nextcloud user with this password. And now that this is done, we can quit this and exit the container. We don't need to use this one here anymore. And now we can change back to our browser. So now if we enter this URL again, just clean this up. And by the way, you can see up here, this connection is secure and we have a Let's Encrypt certificate for this domain. Okay, now we can create a user admin, give it a password, click install, and now it's going to work. Just takes a few seconds. After it's done creating the admin user, it's going to ask us to install the first couple of apps. I will just install those recommended apps. They will take a minute or two. This is how it looks like after it's done installing those initial apps. Right now, there's only the dashboard, files, photos, talk, that's for chatting, mail, contacts, calendars, and notes. I'm going to install a password manager as well. And I'm also going to take care of those security points in here, but I'm going to make an extra video for that. And if you're not sure yet, if you want to run your own Nextcloud, then I invite you to use this Nextcloud to try it out. You can just enter the URL cloud.thisisadminhub.com. You can register in here, just enter your email and request a verification link and follow the instructions. After that, you can log in here. Let's do that real quick. You can also activate two-factor authentication, just like what I have here. And in here, you just go to the welcome widget. You can chat me in here. Just send me a screenshot that you subscribed and I will give you for free 10 gigabytes of cloud storage just to play around here. And you can use all those apps in here, even the password manager. That's working fine and is completely secure. If you have any questions about this setup here, about installing Nextcloud, let me know that in the comments down below, or you can even chat me in our cloud. I will be available there as well. That's it for today. Thanks for watching and see you next time.